The first session of sharing our faith. How might we tell or proclaim God's story? You'll see in the notes that I draw inspiration from that great 104th Psalm and also from that earliest witness, Paul, writing to the church in Corinth in terms of trying to explain and share this remarkable story, this great event of God's interruption in human history, in the life, the ministry, the death, and the resurrection, and the expected return of Jesus Christ. It is obviously difficult. There is a sense in which there are a variety of differences in terms of our temperament and our ways of sharing good news. But my hope and prayer is that not only will we believe and practice our faith, but that also we will share it in a variety of ways, both using words and explanation and sharing it in our deeds and our acts of compassion. I believe it is a story worth telling. It is a story of grace. It is a story that still makes a profound difference in people's lives. It is a story that invites into a community. It is a song worth singing. It's a song of liberation. People have found in biblical passages and biblical images and biblical motifs a sense in which they are invited into this great liberating drama that is God's engagement with the world. Whether it be Moses leading his people out, or whether it be the poor finding a renewed home in a community responding to the continued presence of Christ. It's an event worth proclaiming. In the Christian faith, obviously, our hearts are deeply rooted in the saving action of God made real in Jesus Christ, in his ministry and teaching, yes, and then obviously in his self-offering love, in crucifixion, and in the triumphant vindication by the ways of God's Spirit in his resurrection and continued presence in the life of the witnessing community, which is the church down through the ages. And so when we come to the basics of the story, I like to think of four points of a compass or four seasons of a year. Firstly, the sense of creation. We are created. Creation is good. We've mentioned that before. Creation is very good. Creation, in a sense, is the exploration and the delight of life. We don't necessarily need to know all the hows and the whys of creation. We've already explored the possibility that God creates as Father. In other words, creation is a celebration of being created by God for God, or by love, in love for love. We are those who want to share something of the mystery of God's love for us with the wider world. There is, however, especially in the Christian tradition, and many complain about this, they think it's a negative assessment of humanity and shouldn't we have a higher assessment? But the reality is, in lived experience, we see it all around us. There is a difficulty in terms of what Christians like to call sin. There is a brokenness, there is a despair, there is a disconnect. There is a sense of falling short. There is a sense of betrayal and denial. There is a sense of corruption and crime and violence and war. And yes, no doubt, Christians have played their role and are sinners too. And in that way, we are invited to kneel together at the cross, make our confession, and be renewed in what it means to be a forgiven people. And that's the third sense, the third point of the compass, salvation. We are invited into wholeness. Salvation has been understood, explored, and explained in a variety of ways. In recent times, it's been seen basically as the individual being saved for something beyond this life. But really, biblically speaking, salvation is an invitation into wholeness in the fullest possible understanding of that term. A renewed relationship with God, a renewed relationship within ourselves, a renewed relationship with our neighbors, and increasingly, in the world, a renewed relationship with creation, a renewed relationship understanding our connection with life and life shared not only amongst fellow human beings, but indeed on a planet that proves fragile. So the fourth point is either church or discipleship, a joining in a community, and that community is a matter of conviction often. But joining in a community that is prepared to grapple with what does it mean to say yes to the ongoing sense of God. And so when we are sharing our faith, we remind people that indeed they are created in the image of God, We share a sense in which we, together with them, fall short and are in need of healing. We offer healing in and through the invitation of Jesus Christ to a life of transformation. And we join together to pray and work out and share that life with others. Sharing our faith, it's difficult, but it is possible. By the grace of God, may 2018 be a year where we share our faith. Amen.